Can you state your name and the subject you teach at East Hollywood High School?
Yeah, my name is Spencer Holt, and I am a film teacher here at East Hollywood High School.
My name is William McAllister, and I teach film production at East Hollywood High School.
Hi, I'm Nolan May, and I'm the assistant principal at East Hollywood High School.
Jordan Jarman, life sciences.
Sure, my name is Thomas Knighton, and I teach history and current issues.
How does it feel to be involved in several meme pages and have your own fan page on social media?
Strange, a little bit, is what I would say. I would say because those pages are generally really positive, like it doesn't make me feel bad, which is good. Like, they're not like mean-spirited necessarily, or like making fun of me in like really aggressive ways or anything like that. Like, it's mostly harmless. There's a couple posts that like I don't enjoy, but generally speaking, like, all of it is positive. That said, like, there are teachers who like don't have that same level of positivity in their discussion online, and that's pretty frustrating to see some of my colleagues be treated that way.
I am always honored to be part of the school and to be part of the culture here.
I didn't know I had a fan page on social media. Do I really? Or is that just Spencer?
You're on a lot.
Or do I show up on Spencer's? I live in a world of ignorance because I just like walk around with a flip phone. This is my little guy. And I don't usually, I'm not very social media inclined. So I didn't realize it was happening. And you know what? Ignorance is bliss. So I feel fine.
It's a mixture of flattering and truly horrifying. Sometimes more horrifying, but sometimes fun. I don't know. It's mixed.
I started a meme page for my science class, and it has been amazing, actually. It's a way for me to be able to tell whether or not my students actually understand the concept that I'm talking about, because if they laugh at the joke, if they understand the joke, and I know they understand the content.
Does it make you paranoid?
Yeah, I would say there was, especially towards the beginning, there was a little bit of that paranoia of what was gonna end up on there, whether it was from like my old social media or from like in class, people taking pictures or videos. Since I have found out who runs the account, I'm less like worried about it. I talked to them and they were nice about it. They were good about it, so I don't know.
No, it doesn't make me paranoid at all. I expect it, and I would be surprised if I wasn't part of the online social media presence of our school. It's just something I expect.
You know, I don't think so. I bet if I dwelled upon the fact that it was out there, I'd start to feel, I could possibly find myself getting nervous about it, but I honestly don't think about it. So I think I'm okay. Actually, I mean, now that this is new news to me, I might start getting paranoid. Who knows?
There was like the whole shoe thing for a second, and they were taking pictures in the bathroom, which is weird. But I mean, I don't have a fan page. I don't have anything like that. I guess I've kind of just skirted under the radar with it, but.
I try not to let any of my students' opinions affect me at all, because there are a lot of them, and I just gotta keep doing my thing.
Is it something you wish wasn't happening?
You know, I like when people bring positivity into this world. Like, if people are getting enjoyment out of it, it doesn't like bother me necessarily. But I will say that like the account that follows me is doing positive stuff, whereas there are other accounts that are more negative, or posting things without consent, or posting things that I feel like probably shouldn't be posted, whether it's like the feed account or some of the others that can be mean-spirited. Like, if it was all fun and games, like, all positive, like, yeah, go for it. But whenever you start to lean into that, like, cyberbullying of people who are teachers here trying to help you, like, that sucks. I don't like it.
Do you think the students here see you as a regular person?
I think if the students really spend the time thinking about it, they would come to that realization pretty quickly. But I think a lot of students don't see the adults at the school as being real people with real feelings. I think that it's hard for them to come to that conclusion. I think we do a better job than most schools. As you're aware, all of the staff here go by our first names. We don't have separate faculty bathrooms. We try very hard to be part of your lives and to break down those barriers. I mean, you don't see me wearing a suit very often. We try to be pretty casual while maintaining a level of professionalism.
No, I don't. The like point of fact being like just being a teacher, it's a different type of relationship. It's that mentor type of position. Some people interpret that different, and everybody has different reactions. I would say, for example, if I see a student outside of school, they like the shock on their face of like seeing a teacher out in the wild is like proof of like how I am treated different, and that relationship is something that's unique. I think it's generally speaking, like, I love that relationship. I love being able to teach and be able to help people and guide people and create those. It's not necessarily quite like a friendship, but it has those same qualities of like being there for a person, listening to a person. That's why I like to teach. I like the people and the students. I like to get to interact with that. I think that's something really special. So.
I like to think so. I try. I talk about my family a lot. We do have lives sometimes outside of school.
As regular as a person can be at East Hollywood, how's that? I think that when it comes down to it, I feel like everybody at the school has a pretty good grasp of what normal is and isn't, and that our ideas of normal don't really exist, I guess. It's just a construct. I think they think I'm normal enough, if that makes any sense whatsoever.
I don't think so. I don't think so, and that's okay. Here's the thing. When I was going to high school, teachers definitely, we never saw them as regular people. Teachers were teachers, and if you did happen to see them at the grocery store or at the zoo or something, it was weird. It was like, oh no, you're not supposed to be here. My life and my school life should never cross. But I feel like East Hollywood High School is a little bit different, where we foster a different kind of relationship here. The students and the teachers, I think, have a better relationship of trust. And so because of that, I feel like there is a level of, I think it kind of levels the playing field, and students and teachers alike can start to see each other as people and not as weird others out in the world. So 100%, I don't think so, but I think they see me more as a real person than they would if I was teaching at another school, if that makes sense.